The Cleaver plan laid out the plans and the funding for 18 and vine for this district. Congressman Cleaver was a young man once. I tell him, I tell kids that, and he said, Dr. Kermer, that's not funny. Leona Ponce Thurman was the first black woman to practice law. Sarah Rector at one point was the richest black woman in the country. This is the home of a formerly enslaved woman, Lucy. All of these people, all of these places did have community remembrance projects because they understand the importance of doing this, of acknowledging this happened, and now they can heal. Now, before I came here, I was a teacher. Every single semester for 28 years in my African American Studies class, a student would say, why didn't we learn about this in high school?
25 states have introduced bills or taken other steps to restrict education on racism and bias.
We're about teaching history in an objective way that is not represented as America is systemically racist.
Critical race theory is racist.
I will do everything I possibly can to fight to the bitter end until you prove to me that you are not teaching my children that they are racist just because they're white.
Quit indoctrinating our children via CRT. America is not racist.
This hateful, divisive material teaches teachers to hate America and ultimately break every person down into privileged and the oppressed. This is the exact definition of critical race theory. It needs to be stopped immediately, and parents need assurances that this hateful, divisive material will not be built into our curriculum.
When you're talking about critical race theory, so it's something that really only researchers are using. In the 1960s, all these laws were passed during the Civil Rights Movement in hopes to bring greater equality for people of color, in particular Black people, right? But then by the time the 1970s rolled around, we saw that, man, it doesn't really seem like it's gotten that much better. What is going on? When Crenshaw and Bell were looking at the realities of the legal system and laws and were saying, the equity is not there. The equality is not there. What is happening?
Basically, if a system is created by people who are deeply racist against another group, then that institution will reflect the racism of the people who created it. Now, this is all sort of higher level thinking that people debate in graduate school classrooms. And so the idea that someone is teaching anything close to that at the elementary school level or the middle school level or even the high school level is ludicrous. What people who are protesting about critical race theory are really protesting is the lessons about historic racism in America's past and the discussion of systemic racism in America today. When George Floyd was killed, sort of the debate over the effect of systemic racism in policing was essentially over. So people who are trying to stop America from facing the legacy of its systemic racism had to find a new way to push back. What they're trying to do is make teachers afraid to talk about America's history of racism and make teachers afraid of talking about how systemic racism works in America today.
And in the end, I think what's happened is that people have personalized this entire conversation about race. You know, and when you critique stuff that people revere, like the story of Columbus sailing here on the ocean blue, or like the fact that anybody can come here and build themselves up on the basis of meritocracy, when you begin to unravel that, what you don't just unravel a historical narrative, but you're unraveling people's sense of themselves. But part of the political rhetoric has been to twist a story about white history and the dominance of white history in this country in order to say all white people are bad. That's not what it means at all.
What's happened is the misinformation about CRT has caused people to think any teaching about race at all is CRT. When you're talking about diversity, equity, and inclusion, and making sure that kids feel like they're a part of the curriculum, feel like they see themselves represented in history, feel like they see people like them making contributions to humanity and making the world a better place, to empowering them in their own agency. Critical race theorists might say, that's really good work. That could start to really tackle some of these issues we're looking at. But that doesn't mean that those things are rooted in CRT.
And I wish the parents that are so vocal about it really truly understood what this work is about. You know, I loved English, but I always struggled while I was going through those classes, where is my story? And I felt so defeated. I didn't want my students to ever feel that way, that they would be free to read stories that reflected their experience. It's all literature written by Latinos who have lived here in the United States, have had some kind of experience here in the United States, were exiles here in the United States. This is American literature. Here, most of them are seniors. They're 18 years old, about to graduate, and they haven't read anything written by a Latino. They've never had a Latina teacher ever before. A lot of times it's not even taught at all. You know, we're still doing English. You're still learning about history, but it's just a different story. It's another side to it.
If you're a young Black person who has a family with history of chattel slavery, or if you're a young Indigenous person whose tribe or nation was obliterated in the process of colonization, if you're a young Latino or Latina or Latinx person whose family is struggling with border issues, when we erase those stories, we're not just erasing the story in history, we're erasing people. And that's huge. You cannot live in a world that's ruled by race and not have absorbed some of that in some way, regardless of if you're a person of color or a white person. We're all swimming in it.
If we erase all hints of racism from the curriculum, that doesn't mean it goes away. It means we give it a pass. Because there's this thing called the null curriculum, which means it's not written down anywhere, but everybody's learning it.
Three incidents in 3 weeks. Suburban schools across the metro are investigating racially charged situations on and off school grounds.
This all began last Wednesday when students at Park Hill South High School passed around a petition to reinstate slavery.
Sometimes kids think they're being funny. It's not funny. It's hurtful. But maybe they don't understand that.
And the fact of the matter is, if we don't talk about racism in school, kids won't have a safe place to grapple with some of these issues and be provided with information and with sources to be able to find answers to their questions.
You know, I have a lot of well-meaning people who say, I'm colorblind. And I tell them, please don't be. Because if you're colorblind, the first color to disappear is black. And then you don't see me. If you don't see me as a black woman, you have missed the essence of who I am. So don't be colorblind. Accept it, acknowledge it, and then think about it.
It's really a space to have those conversations so that you can literally grow from it. You know, I'll have students that break down in tears because this is so heavy for them. But just like any struggle, right, you get stronger from it.
Our public schools are meant to help all kids. And even people that are running for school board on anti-CRT agenda when they don't even know what it is, they still have a responsibility to all of these students.